Well, my name's Tom, and I've been setting for quite a long time, maybe 10 years or so. And I first started working in London, then I moved up to Sheffield, and then I travelled all around setting for different centres, doing competition setting and things. And now I have the station here, which is my own wall, and it's nice to kind of plough all my years of love of route setting to one place. It's really
Yeah,
nice.
sweet place as well, so congratulations.
Thanks.
How do you select a brand over another one when you choose halls?
I think the main thing for us here in terms of choosing climbing holds is that they have to have a really diverse range. So they're good on flat surfaces, on steep, on roof, on slab, and there's something suitable for everything rather than trying to fit something onto a surface that doesn't work. And so whenever you get your box of holds and you lay them out on the floor, you go, oh, look at this, I could do this, that, and immediately it conjures up ideas rather than everything being the same or very, very basic.
Okay.
Yeah.
And in terms, so you've just received a big delivery of Volks holes. Why pick Volks over another brand, or what makes them special? Why do you like them, or do you like them?
Yeah,
Yeah, of course.
Cool.
What chose? I think the one thing I really liked about Volks was that when I was going through the catalogue and looking through the ranges, is that you pick themes, but when you look at the themes, they're quite kind of seamless with other products within the range. So you can say, oh, I want to take this font theme here, but I have these footholds that aren't particularly from that same range. And you can see they go together and they match.
Yeah.
Some brands that you look at the climbing holds, you just know it will look so disjointed with a problem from the something range and plus the other range, so you know that you're not able to mix very well within your setting, and I think your holds work well like that.
And in terms of when you're setting a problem, do you have your top three tips for route setting? What would they be?
Have a look at them and see whether there's anything in the design of the hold, of how the carver put them together, that leads you to put together a certain sequence. So when I look at it, I go, oh, if they created that hold so that it's some sort of match, or does it lead that you want to hold the top of the hold at the top and then come underneath in it, and let the hold dictate to some extent the sequence that you use out of it, because then the problem will feel really, really natural.
Yeah.
And I think that you can go a long way just by listening to the holds.
Would you say it's obvious, an obvious question, but is it easier to set good problems when you have good holes? And does it make a difference in the grand scheme of things to your center, whether you have good holes? Could you not achieve the same thing with cheap holes or just basic?
Oh yeah, I mean, it makes a massive difference. Not just on whether you produce good problems, because I think actually a good setter will be able to produce really good problems off very basic cheap holds. But what it'll mean is that, say you have 8 hours of setting to do in a day, and you have excellent holds that are amazing for the job, then you'll produce however many boulder problems. But if you have terrible holds, you'll probably produce half the number of boulder problems, because you spend your whole time going, ah, what are these things on the floor? I'm going to have to work so hard to make this good.
Okay.
So it essentially improves the efficiency. So you end up, as a centre, paying a lot less money to, hiring your freelance route setters, because you're giving them a good job to do rather than one where they pull their hair out because they've got crap to work with.
Okay.
Ultimately, you want the person who comes in the door at the beginning of the day to come in a certain mood, and when they leave, to be a lot happier. And if you do that time and time again, then they keep coming back to your centre. So if you've got amazing holds, then I think someone walks away and goes, oh, I've never seen those holds before anywhere else. Like, for example, Volks, I know that there's not that many of them in the country, and especially in this region,
Yeah.
in the walls. So I know that anyone who comes here will have a unique experience on these holds, and I'm over the moon when they walk away and go, whoa, that was cool.
Well, thanks for sharing all your tips. This was great. So, yeah, let's have a look at the setting.
they're good. There's a good amount of variation in the holes. There's a lot of small, tricky footholds that I'm not keen on, but they are pretty good. And a lot of variation in the slopers, which is good. And the big one, which has got the dyno. That was pretty fun. Yeah, pretty good. I like them.
Okay, hello. So you're enjoying the competition tonight then?
Really good fun, really good competition. Yeah, really good race, like quite hard though, but yeah.
Did you like the holds you were climbing on?
Yeah, they were really like really grippy, but different shapes as well. So depending on what like position you're in, they were really good in some shapes and then not so good in the others. And I really like the big ball, big slopers, so they were good fun.
So which one was your favourite problem?
This one actually, right behind us. It's like big slopers, two big slopers, and then you think that's a jug, but it's not. It's a little one. And it's just quite technical. You have to move your feet around, and because like the holds are really good as well. So you like different sides of the slopers are better and not so good at the same time, so it's good.
Cool, lots of variety then.
Yeah, loads of variety. Yeah, it was really good.
Hi Diane, so we're at the Loughborough climbing station today doing the comp. I was wondering, did you enjoy the comp?
I did enjoy the comp, yeah. It was really, really good fun. Great holds, keep me guessing because it's the first time I've been on them.
Cool, so did you, like, is there any particular problem you really enjoyed or particular shape? Like, did you find something special about the holds?
I enjoyed the problem on the vert around the corner, it was quite slopey, but just like little subtle grooves within the holds, and you find them and you're like, yay!